What's the best tool that we can use for making thumbnail images for our YouTube videos? I'm going to show you a great tool in this video that it's actually free. You just have to put up with the advertising on the side. It's quite a sophisticated tool, so you can either do very simple thumbnails or you can actually make quite sophisticated thumbnails, bringing in different pictures, adding text, etc. I'm going to take you through a whole spectrum of activities. Really hope you like the video, and as always, if you do, please like it, please share it with other people, please comment on it. Love to know what you think of Photopea, and of course join me on my YouTube channel. Let's get started. So here's the technology we're going to use. It's called photopea.com. It's completely free. You do need a fairly good internet connection because you're doing everything online. Let's start with something quite simple, as I said, and then I'm going to show you more and more and more sophisticated ideas. So let's click on new project. And the one that we need to click on is screen, because we want to choose this size, 1280 pixels by 720. That's the kind of standard thumbnail size at the moment. Notice that this is high definition. Just click on that and you're going to see that it's going to bring up a whole range of possible examples. I'm just going to quickly grab one to use to start with. So we'll click on this. So just click on it once and it will open on the screen. So that is the perfect thumbnail size. Now if you look over here on the right hand side, you'll see that actually this is quite sophisticated. It works by layers, and these layers are brilliant because we can add text or add another picture into a layer and combine it. So let's start with just editing these layers to show you how easy it is to do. So the brilliant thing about these layers is that they give us lots of control. So let's say I want to change what is love. So I just click on that layer, double click on the screen, and I'm going to change that to, for example, Russell Stannard, okay, which is my name. And then if I wanted to move that, because I've got that layer already selected, just click on the move tool, and then I could say, right, I'm going to move that up there. Okay, so immediately I've already got the perfect size for my thumbnail. Now I might, and I'll show you this on the second one, I'm going to click on the second layer and I'm going to change this one. It says baby don't hurt me, and I'm going to click on here and I'm going to first of all change that to Photopea training. Okay, so let's imagine that I'm making a thumbnail for this video. Now what I can also do again is click on that, okay, or actually I can select it because I've already got it selected here. I'm already on that layer, so I can just hold my mouse down and select the text. Then I could come up here and I could completely change it. So I'm saying, right, I'm going to make it bigger, and I might obviously even want to change the actual fonts. If I click here, it gives me a whole range of, and there's literally hundreds of fonts that I could go through here, but let's just quickly grab one as an example. So let's say I look like the look of this one here. I could click on that and that will change it again. I might come back afterwards to the size and get that nice and big, and then even I might decide, well, I want to use a different color text, so I'm going to click here and perhaps let's give it an example. I just click on that, okay, and then I'm going to click here, so we're going to switch that over, click on OK, and then if I now click away from this by just clicking on the move tool again, it now selected that and chose a different color. And because I've got the move tool selected, remember I'm on this layer and I've got the move tool selected, I can now just move that to where anywhere else I wanted. Let's say I wanted to put it there to make it nice and clear. So you can just literally grab a already created thumbnail and just change it the way you would like it to look. And that's one of the brilliant things about working with Photopea. Now, just to take this slightly further, if I wanted to add another layer of text, okay, so what I'm going to do here is come down to the text tool, just click on the screen. It will use the same font as you was using in the previous example, unless you change it, but let's say Photopea training, free technology, okay. So if I wanted to say, for example, highlight the fact that it was a free technology. Now what, again, I've got this new layer selected, so I'm just gonna hold my mouse down and select that, and then I might come back and say, well, actually I want that to be another color, so perhaps I'm gonna choose for this one, let's do a gray color and see how that works out. Okay, click on OK, Again, click on the move tool now because we want to move it back to somewhere, and then we can put that on the screen. That's probably not clear enough. I'm probably going to want to use a different color to get that text really clear. So all I would need to do, because I've got it selected, double click again, come back here, let's choose perhaps yellow. Let's see how that works out. Okay, click on OK. And then again, click on the move tool to deselect it. And now that's a lot better. And now I can kind of move it into position. Okay, I'm doing a really quick example. You could work with any of the different fonts that you want to work with and colors that you want to work with in images. I'm now going to show you something a little bit more sophisticated, but you get the idea of how you can work with these tools. Now, once you've made all your changes and you're happy, just go up to here, File, and click on Export As. Choose a JPEG that's generally smaller. Give it a title. So I'm going to call this one here My Thumbnail. And then simply save it. Now, one thing to keep in mind, all of the thumbnails that you save will be saved in your downloads. So if you click now on your computer and go to your downloads, you will see that My Thumbnail is already there. So the next thing that we're going to look at is how to bring in real pictures to make your thumbnails more interesting. So using pictures from your own computer. Now, you might want some tips about how to design a really good thumbnail. And if you are interested, I've got a video on the screen now, 5 golden rules when designing a thumbnail. You might find that really interesting. If you want to learn more about Photopea and working with real pictures, just carry on watching this video. So let's do another example, but this time we're going to work with a graphic. So in fact, I don't need to do that. I'm just going to click here. All I need to do this time is to click on Open from Computer. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a picture. Now we have to remember that what we're really looking for is that whatever picture we use, we want the image size to be 1280 pixels across by 720. So I'm going to click on this picture here. I'm going to just show you what we can do very quickly with an image. Now we don't know if that's the perfect size, so what we can do is click on image and come down to look at the image size. Now this one at the moment is 720 pixels by 694, so it's actually quite similar to the right size. It's not quite right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this button here because I don't want to connect. I'm just going to change that to 1280, and I don't want this one to automatically update. I want to do this manually. See, it's automatically updated. So if I click on there, and now I should be able to click over and click on 720 and click on OK. And that image now is the perfect size. And if I come back to the image size now, you'll notice that it's 1280 pixels across by 720. That's the perfect size. So we've got our image now at the perfect size. But of course, we could start adding layers to this image and adding text, etc. So watch this. I'm going to click now on the text tool. Notice immediately, as soon as I click on the screen, it adds a text layer. So if I now start writing, let's say, for example, this thumbnail is going to be about my new Moodle course. So Moodle training. Okay, now again, I might not be happy with the font that I've chosen. So I can just, because I've got that layer selected, just hold my mouse down, select it, okay? And then come up to here. I could choose another color. So I'm going to go, for example, this time for a kind of white color. And then the other thing I'm going to do, so I'm going to click on OK, is I'm going to come back here and totally change the font that I want to use. Now, you've got absolutely masses of fonts, masses and masses of them. So you've really got to spend your time working out which one you want to, use. I'm going to try this one here. Okay, quite like that. I'm now going to click on the move tool because I want to now move that into position. Okay, so obviously I can work with my own pictures. Now remember, you can add whatever you want to a layer. We could even take this further. Certainly we might want to add some more text, so we might come down to here, click on the screen again. Again, it's going to add a new layer for us, and we're going to say Moodle training, making let's say a complete course. Okay, again. So I've written the word out. What I'm going to do now is click on the move tool. I'm going to move that down to the bottom. Okay, if I'm happy now, again, I might decide that I want to use a different font, etc. But you can see how easy it is to take a picture. The important thing is with the picture is try to get a picture that is already wider than it is high. Because remember, you always want finally to have an image that's 1280 pixels across and 720 pixels down. Don't forget, when you want to save it, click on File, come down to Export As. I would export it as a JPEG. So click on that one there and then give it a title. So I'm going to call this, for example, Thumbnail. Always want to make sure you've given it a title. Just delete the old title that's there, Thumbnail number one, so 01, and then click on Save. And that will be saved in your download. So now you could upload that thumbnail into your YouTube course. Now I'm going to really show you now how to take Photopea to another level. So if you really want to produce a quite sophisticated thumbnail, how you can have various pictures in the image, various pieces of text, how you can work with the layers, that's the next part of the video. If you are interested in a little bit more about how you set up a YouTube channel and what how I've been quite successful with my channel, particularly working in YouTube for education, which is my kind of specialist area, then I'm putting a video on the screen now that you might find interesting. Otherwise, let's carry on with Photopea and let's push the level up even further. Whenever you want to close a project down, once you've saved the project, of course, just click here. Let's start a new one. This time we're going to try and do something a little bit more sophisticated. So I'm going to click on Open from Computer again. I'll grab an image and I'm going to take this one here. I'm going to open that onto the screen. First thing I need to do is go Image and come down to Image Size, because I need to make sure that it's the right size. Now, I'm going to just show you something. If I change this 1280, and then I click inside here, you'll notice it updated automatically. That is because I've got this as on, and that means that it will automatically adjust the height depending on the width. So this is called, it maintains the aspect ratio. Now in this particular case, I don't want that because I need this to be 720, so I'm going to turn that off. And then I'm just going to change that to 720, okay? Click on OK. Now, just a really quick break from the video. I hope you're enjoying the video, and if you are, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free videos that you can access. You can also find out about all my courses. They're always advertised on the opening page. And please sign up to the newsletter. If you sign up to the newsletter, you get updated with all the blog posts, the webinars, the online courses, and the videos. And at the moment, if you sign up, there is a 12-part free video course in using technology in teaching. And I send you a video about every 5 days. Let's get back to the video. I really hope I can show you now some of the power of the fact that we've got these layers. Let me start by, obviously, sometimes what we do when we're writing a title is that we kind of put a banner behind it or a band behind it to make it really clear. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come down to here and I'm going to choose to add a rectangle. Notice the color. I'm quite happy with that color, but I could obviously change it, but I'm going to go with that color. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a band about here. Okay, that will do, shouldn't be too big. See, and then what I can do is now I can write the text on top of that. Now notice that immediately adds a new layer, okay? And notice that just like the text, I could now move that layer around. Now let's imagine now that I want to add some text to go over that layer. So what I'm going to do now is going to click on text. And I don't need to put it in here. I can just write it and then move it on top. So what I'm going to do is, and I'm just going to click on the screen again. Notice the text layer is now on the screen. And notice the text layer is above. It's on a higher layer than this kind of rectangle. So if I start to write now, and I'm just going to write my name. I'm just going to write Russell. That will do. I'm going to click on the Move tool. And I'm going to now put that inside of the band. And you see this technique used all the time. Now I'm going to take this even further. Watch this. This is a really clever thing that we can do. I want another band, and I want the band to be exactly the same size. So I'm going to click on the band, I'm going to right click on that particular layer, and I'm going to click copy duplicate layer. And now we have another layer. Now I know that that layer, this new one, the copy is higher than this one. So if I click on that and click on the move tool, I should be able to grab it and move it somewhere else. So let, for example, I want that one there. And let's say I wanted to write my name again. So what I'm going to do is click on I'm going to put my second name. I'm going to click on text. And I'm going to do exactly the same. It's created that as soon as I click on the screen, it's going to create a new layer. And I can see that that layer is above this one, which is the important thing. I always want the text layer to be above the layer where I've got this kind of background fill. That's really important. I'm just going to write my second name. So I'm going to write Stannard. And again, I'm going to click on the move tool and move it into place. So these layers are really powerful. They take a bit of practice. Now I will do a more sophisticated video about Photopea, because it really is a very sophisticated tool, and there are many things in fact that I don't even use that I know it can do. But just to point out a couple of things, when you're working in Photopea, one thing that you might sometimes want to do is lock a layer so that you can't accidentally touch it. So if you click on any layer, you can always click on the lock button, and that locks it. You can then unlock it. That can be really useful. Another thing to remember, and this can sometimes be useful, is that you might sometimes not want a certain layer to be visible, and you can actually turn layers on and off. Now another thing with Photopea is you can undo what you've done. The easiest thing to do is, there's various ways of doing this, you can come up to edit and just simply step forward or undo. You've always got those two options, okay? But you can always, what I tend to do is I use, especially when I'm going backwards, I will just use Control Z, and that is the way to kind of go backwards if you've made a mistake and you want to undo it. Okay, so you've got that. I'm going to put that back in. Now, as I said, there is a lot more I can do. I'm going to just show you one final thing. Now I'm just going to show you one more really important thing about Photopea that I know is going to be really important to you if you're making thumbnails. Watch this. You can add a second picture into the picture. So if you come up to File and the one that you want is Open and Place. Now let's imagine, for example, that I'm going to do, this is going to be something about using Moodle. So if I've got a copy of the Moodle logo, and I have, I'm going to click on that. I'm going to click on open, and that comes onto the screen. And of course, it's on another layer. And of course, that means I can now click on move tool and position that wherever I want it on the screen. So you can start to see how useful working with these layers is. And again, once you finish, then you can click on File, and obviously we're going to click on, for example, Export As. We export this as a JPEG, click on that, give it a name. So we're going to call this again Thumbnail New, and then click on Save, and there it is on the screen, completely designed and ready to upload onto or into your YouTube course or your YouTube video. Really hoped you liked that video. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free content, and you can see all of my courses on the opening page. Don't forget to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the latest blog posts, the webinars, the latest videos and the courses. Of course, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell. That way you'll get all the updates. And finally, if you do want to contact me, perhaps about doing a conference or doing some training with your organization, you can contact me from the website. Thank you very much. On the screen now, you'll see some more free videos on technologies that are connected with teaching.